Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Here we'll take a look how to use Firebase batch committing, or how to commit batches of operation at the same time so that you can create collections, document, sub-collections, documents, and a lot of fields together. Now over here we'll see that this is a method, and this method gets called from the UI from a button click. And as it gets called, first here we get the Firebase reference for Firestore. Now, FI refers to the Firebase Firestore instance. Now, I put it in a separate file. You can put it anywhere you want. And once I have this object reference FI, now I can access the method which is called batch. Now, I save it in a variable called batch. You can name it anything you want. Now, since I'm going to submit a batch operation to Firebase and it has to do with user, so first here I check if I have a user or not. If the user is null, then we just return. But in your case, you might not have a user. You could do anything with the Firebase database. So you may use this, you may skip this. It doesn't really matter. Now right after this, we see this batch object, the one we created at the top, and it has a function which is called a set. Now inside set, actually, if you hover over on it, you will see that you have to have a document reference at the end, and there are some data options. Now over here, first you have to get the collection reference. So user fr actually a collection name, as you can see here. So it's a Firebase collection name. So once again, we are getting it from fi. Because fi, I created a global variable, so we can access it from anywhere. So using this fi, we get a collection of users. Name is users. Well, of course, if this collection doesn't exist, Flutter will create it automatically. So over here, we get users collection, right? And for that user, we have a document. Now, if the document doesn't exist, it will create one. Now in my case, this is dynamic because user could be anyone. So whoever the user is, whatever the email address, we go ahead and save it and create a document. For you, it could be hard-coded or dynamic as well, or any other name. And then we create another hard-coded collection for this document. So actually it becomes a sub-collection. Now for this sub-collection, we create another document. So here we have collection, document, sub-collection, sub-documents like that. Now in your case, you might just have a document and then you do rest of the things. Anyway, so after this document, here we create some fields. What fields we create? We create points, correct count, paper ID, and time. Now these are some dynamic data. So in your case, you can use any kind of data you want. It doesn't matter. So the idea is, if we want to create batch operation or submit or commit batch operation, we have to create a batch object from Firebase Firestore. And then for that object, we have to call the set function. Now set function has to take at least one document or a sub-collection document, sub-documents, and some related fields. Now in your case, you might just have one document, and then you can go ahead and create some fields. So this is the first batch of operation that we want to create. Then we have another one. Over here, once again, this is also a collection name. If you click on this, you will see that this is also a collection name. Now for that collection, we get documents, and you create a sub-collection, and then we have another document that we create. And after that, actually, we go ahead and create some new fields for this collection. And at the end, this is the syntax that we should run, which is called batch.commit. Now with this, we'll create a lot of collections and sub-collection documents and sub-documents at the same time. Now we are going to do it in real world. So let's take a look with the real example. Now here I have only one collection, which is called quiz papers. Now, if we create this batch operation over here, we'll see that we have If we do this batch operation over here, we'll see that we'll have user collection, letter paper, and related email documents and quiz paper documents. The same over here. Now, let's go ahead and submit a batch operation. So I'm going to go ahead very quickly and I'm going to submit it over here. So this is the place. If I go ahead and submit, and we'll see that over here we'll have new collections, and that would happen because of batch operation. Now, if we do that one at the bottom, actually we'll see that there is a print message, okay, which means that it ran over here. Now let's go ahead and submit this. Okay, well, it happened very quickly. Now we do see that here we have this batch committing the printing message. And after that, we navigate to home where we see the home route. Great. Now at the back end, we're gonna go ahead and check it. So we're going to refresh our database over here. So it's refreshing. And we do see that over here we have quiz paper letterboard, the one we have seen over here. This is the letterboard collection, and we also have users collection. So letterboard collection has document, scores, and sub documents, and these are the fields that we created. These are the fields that we created, as you can see over here: points, correct, count, paper ID, and as well as we also have created a user document, and for that user document we have sub collections over here, as you can see. Let's take a look. So here we have user, email ID as document, and this is the sub collection that we have seen, and more documents and sub collections. So while committing a batch operation may sound scary, but actually it's pretty easy. All you need to do, get a Firestore instance and get a batch object, and then call the set method for that one, and make sure that at least you have one document, and for that document you have this fields.